وقاية. For example, akrama. This is in the Quran. Akrama plus ya becomes akramani. Akramani. He honored me. He honored me. Allamani Rabbi. Allama means taught. Plus ya. It becomes Allamani. So noon comes here. This noon. This is called noon waqaya. Allamani.
Shina, what is it preventing? What is it preventing?
It is preventing from from mixing the verb with the letter, and it prevents the last part from the change. You know, for example, it comes after past tense and future tense, and even with amr, and it comes with inna and huruf jar also. You know, it comes fi'l madi, fi'l mudari, fi'l amr. It comes with inna, anna, and with huruf jar. I will give you some examples. This is akrama is madi. Allama is also madi. Mudare, for example, yu'allimu. Plus ya, it becomes yu'allimuni. Yu'allimuni. Amr. Amr, for example, Fattaku. Ittaku. Or Fattaku. This is Fattaku plus ya. It becomes Fattakuni ya ulil albab. Fattakuni. It comes after inna. Inna plus ya. It becomes innani. And huruf jar, for example, an plus ya. It becomes anni. Anni. Two noons. There was only one noon here, but here annani. And min plus ya. Minni. If you want to take a picture of that. Minni. Noon waqaya. A noon is added. Why it is added? Rule, you know, the simple rule is because Arabs do that. Don't ask in language why. Knife, for example, knife. Why do you have K? Because English they write K, knife. They don't write knife with N. They start with K. Why? Because that's the way it is. In language, you don't ask questions like you do in mathematics. That is ABC of languages. Any language of the world, don't ask why this, because that's what the people say. 0.